Are you looking for a medical school to get the dream MD? Well, Google no more, because today I will be introducing to you Adventist University of the Philippines College of Medicine, the school where I got my MD, and why you should get your MD in there too. So stay tuned and be AUP COM ready with me right now. Hello, future medical doctors. I'm Delsie Marcel Vicente, a graduate of AUP College of Medicine, batch Hirang 2020, and currently a medical intern at Adventist Medical Center, Manila. So, you're wondering, is AUP College of Medicine the school for me? What's the curriculum of AUP College of Medicine? Am I eligible to apply? How much is the tuition fee of AUP College of Medicine? Do they offer scholarships? And can I pass the selection and interview process? Well, keep calm and relax, because we will walk you through all your questions in order to be AUP COM ready. Okay, so first things first, what is AUP College of Medicine? What are its objectives, its goal, and its mission? The Adventist University of the Philippines College of Medicine is one of the six medical schools run by the Seventh-day Adventists worldwide. Its medical program was inaugurated last August 6, 2015, which makes our medical school very young. But what makes AUP COM unique is, number one, its integration with faith and learning. AUP College of Medicine seeks to produce exemplary physicians who emulate the master physician, Jesus Christ, and advocate a transforming healing ministry of the whole person, body, mind, and spirit.
This College of Medicine is being established to be part of the healing ministry of the last days, to produce medical missionaries, to produce Christian medical missionaries, to extend the healing ministry of Jesus, the right hand of the gospel, to open the door for the gospel.
And number two, its outcome-based curriculum, which I will discuss further in this video. You hear it right. AUP College of Medicine is a Christian med school who aims to produce clinicians who are missionary-minded, managers and social mobilizers, sensitive to the diverse health and social needs of the communities they serve, academicians and researchers who have an attitude of a lifelong learner, engaging and participating in medical research and continuing postgraduate medical education. In other words, graduates of AP College of Medicine are known as the 5-star plus physicians. So, what's our curriculum? Well, I mentioned it earlier, AUP COM is an outcome-based curriculum. Learning strategies of AUP College of Medicine are as follows. AUP College of Medicine have an integrated organ system learning. AUP College of Medicine have a hybrid lecture and problem-based learning. Also, community-based learning, faith and learning strategy, and lifestyle-oriented strategy. So what are these things? When I say integrated organ system, it means that all your subjects, which we call blocks in a semester, is divided into organ systems. So subjects in anatomy, physiology, they are all divided by organ system. For example, if you're a first year, way back in my year, if you're studying anatomy, it will be divided into anatomy of the upper extremities, anatomy of the lower extremities, things like that. And all you have to do is learn anatomy of the upper extremity and lower extremity for two to four weeks. I already forget the time frame. Another example of an organ system is you are now in the block cardiology. Then all your lectures will be under the subject of the heart. The anatomy, physio, the clinicals, all just focus on the heart. Then on CMed 115, that's neuroblock, the nervous system, then all your topics, all your subjects will just be focused on the brain. So the anatomy, the physio, and the clinicals will all be focused on the brain. So when we say organ system, just focus on the organ. So what's the advantages of having an integrated organ system? Well, number one, it's not confusing to study. Unlike the traditional med school, their subjects are like a halo-halo. For example, if they have a subject about anatomy, they will be studying anatomy of the heart, the brain, everything in the human body. But in our an organ-based system, you're just gonna focus on that specific organ. So you won't be confused and you will be able to correlate all the things that you've studied in that particular block because all of them are interrelated and is in the same organ system. Another advantage of having an integrated organ system is that if you're studying in a traditional med school, it's common for, especially during exam week, for exams of specific subject to be on the same. For example, on Monday, you have an exam on anatomy. On Tuesday, you have an exam on physio. On Wednesday, you have an exam, a clinical exam. So most of the students tend to sacrifice a specific subject or a specific exam in order to focus more on another subject. Well, if you are in an integrated organ system, your exams, there will always be exams, of course, but if you're having an integrated organ system, there's no need to sacrifice one subject in order to study for another because all the things that you are going to study, they are related. Also, your exams are divided into long exams and then block exams. And all of them are scheduled well or separated well so that you have ample time to study and delve more or appreciate them more while you read your books. Another advantage of an integrated organ system is when you are studying for a specific organ block, for example, I'm studying respiratory block, so all the things I'm studying is about the lungs, it's easier to correlate it clinically because during your first year, apart from the basics like histo, ana, physio, you also have your clinical exposure. You will be going to the hospitals on your first year. That's the reason why we have our white coat on the first year. And the good thing about that is since you are targeting a specific organ, all the clinical correlates or the clinical cases or medical conditions of that specific organ will be discussed in your clinical exposure. And it strengthens your theoretical with the practical. That's one thing I really like about APCOM. Now, what's the disadvantage of having an integrated organ system? This is just my own opinion. Since integrated organ system is focused and you'll be studying the anatomy, the physio, and the clinical correlates of that subject or that block, one of the downsides of that is that turnout of blocks is so fast, you won't have the luxury of time to develop a study habit for that specific block because everything changes so fast. There's a lot of things you need to memorize and learn. Of course, medicine has a lot of information and information overload is very common if you're a medical student. But in an integrated organ system, everything is fast-paced. Unlike in traditional med schools where you have anatomy for 1 year, physio for 1 year, you will be able to establish study habits or study techniques for those subjects. But in an integrated organ system, the turnout is fast. Another disadvantage of an integrated organ system is your exams are not halo-halo like the traditional med school, but your exams, though they are spaced, like the long exams and the block exams, you will always have long exams every week. The thing with that is, if you fail the long exam and in the block exam, it's very difficult for you to get back on track. Unlike in traditional med school, if you fail the prelims, you'll be able to do better on the midterm exams. And if you still didn't have good grades in the midterm, then you'll be able to somehow get yourself up from the finals. In an integrated organ system, if you have a long exam, you have to do well. And then if you have the block exams, which is the exit exam, then you have another block. You really have to take it seriously because it's a one-shot type of exam. If you're not able to get good marks on the long exam and in the final exam or in the block exams, you will be offered a remedial. But if you didn't do well in the remedial, you have to wait next year for that next block again. So for example, you didn't do well in the respiratory block, and the respiratory block is scheduled to happen on the 9th month of the year. Then Next year, you have to repeat that. You have to wait for the 9th month of the year. That's the disadvantage of having an integrated organ system. So what's the catch up here? You have to make sure you have to take all your lung exams and block exams seriously. Okay, so what's the requirements for admission? Well, as you can see in the table, AUP College of Medicine application requirements are as follows. You must be a holder of a baccalaureate degree taken not more than 5 years prior to the filing of the application. And if your baccalaureate degree is not in the pre-medical course, like bio, medtech, nurse, physical therapy, don't be discouraged. Even if you're an education graduate, physicist graduate, or a food tech graduate, you can still be a medical doctor and get that MD. How? All you have to do is take minimum prerequisites of 15 units of biology, 10 units of chemistry, 5 units of physics, 6 units of mathematics, and 12 units of social sciences. So don't be discouraged, even if you're not in a pre-medical degree holder. As long as you have the desire and you have the passion and the will to graduate as a medical doctor, you can do it. Now, you have to make sure that you take an NMAT exam. However, in this pandemic, the NMAT score, I think, was waived because of we are against mass gathering as of the moment. But if the pandemic will be lifted, I think the NMAT score will be one of the prerequisites. So if you're still in the pandemic, then the NMAT score is waived. But if it's not in the pandemic anymore, then an NMAT score of at least 60 and above is preferred. And it should be taken within the last 2 years. You also have to accomplish the AUP College of Medicine application forms, which all those links are in the description below. You can just check them out, click on them, and you'll be able to download them right away. As well as, apart from the application forms, you have to have an official receipt of proof of payment of the application fee. And you can just check on the website, which is also in the description link. You can just click on it and it will redirect you there for the payment details. So we have the degree, the NMAT score, the application form, and then we have to have a certified true copy of the transcript or records. You should also have a certificate of good moral character, 4 copies of a 2x2 recent photo of yours, an NBI clearance, a copy of a birth certificate that is NSO certified, and if you're married, then a copy of the marriage certificate, and then letters of recommendation, 2 from your former science professors at the last school you've attended, and 1 recommendation from your clergy or church leader. This must be individually sealed. I remembered I put recommendation letters in a brown envelope, and it was with a proper return address, and is sent directly to the Dean at Adventist University of the Philippines College of Medicine, Putincahoy, Silang, Cavite, Philippines. So in the brown envelope, at the back of the brown envelope, we wrote the address. And of course, a medical certificate. Last 2020, AUP College of Medicine is now accepting foreign students. And you can check those additional information in the website I provided in the description below. Okay, now tuition fees. How much is the tuition fee if I'm going to study at AUP College of Medicine? Well, if you're a Filipino, a foreigner from SSD, and a foreigner from a non-SSD country, you have different fees. Okay, so how much is the tuition fee? Well, take note, in our batch, we have a 33% discount. In this table, the academic year 2019-2020, the discount went down from 33 to 30%. So I don't know if in the succeeding years, the discount will change. But if you're a Filipino, the tuition fee is 91,000. But if you're going to avail of the dormitory facilities, because AUP College of Medicine students have special dorms where they will be given 1 unit, 2 people can occupy 1 unit, and in those 1 unit, you have your separate rooms. So if you're going to avail that, as well as the cafeteria where you can eat, your total tuition fee would be 138,500 pesos. So if you're far away from home or you're not residing in somewhere near Cavite or Putincahoy, then we highly recommend you to avail of the board and cafeteria because it would make your College of Medicine life easier because the dorms would just be inside the university and it's accessible to you after your classes. Okay, so how about if I'm a foreigner? Well, foreign students are divided into foreign students coming from SSD countries and then foreign students coming from non-SSD countries. If you're a foreign student coming from an SSD country, as you can see in the table, so this is the tuition fee for you. So you also have a 30% discount in the academic year 2019-2020. So always check the recent discounts for the succeeding years if you want to apply to AUP College of Medicine in the future. They also offer the board and cafeteria facility, and of course, the tuition fee would go up. Now, what are the countries under SSD territory? So the countries under the SSD jurisdiction are as follows. So we have Indonesia, we have Singapore, we have Malaysia, Thailand, Myanmar, we have Vietnam, Bangladesh, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, and Brunei, Jerusalem. So these are the countries that are within SSD territory and they have less pay than the foreigners coming from non-SSD countries. So if you're a foreigner coming from a non-SSD territory, then you also have a 30% discount, but this is the fee for you there. Now, do AUP College of Medicine offer scholarship grants? Yes. What are those scholarship grants? I will have an in-depth discussion about that in my next video. So make sure to hit that subscribe button so that you won't miss anything. Now, for the selection and interview process. So going back to the time where I applied and got interviewed, my experience is this. The ones doing the selection and the interview process, they are all very approachable and would make you feel at home. The ones who interviewed me during that time was Dr. Mano and Doc Temple D, and they're very fun and very comfortable to be with. It was actually my first time meeting them and talking to them, but they make me feel at ease. So they're not I don't know about how other med schools conduct their interview, but one thing I can guarantee you, in AUP College of Medicine, the interview process is not as terrorizing as you think. So don't be shy or don't be scared to apply. If you've been turned down by the medical schools you've applied before, don't be scared applying to AP College of Medicine because the faculty here and the staff are very approachable and they're very welcoming. So there you have it. We've got a run through of all your questions. I will have more videos about scholarship as well as experiences of foreign students because our batch is very lucky to have a foreign student and she will be sharing her experiences. Is it worth it studying in AUP College of Medicine as a foreign student? So stay tuned. Don't forget to click that subscribe button so you won't miss anything. And I'll see you on another video about AUP COM Ready. I'm Delsie Martel Vicente, providing you Med Remedy.